Welcome to today's On This Day in Tudor History. I'm Claire Ridgway. I run the Tudor Society and Anne Boleyn Files websites, and I've also written several Tudor history books. I do apologise for any sounds in the background. It is impossible to find a quiet place today with building work going on, tiles being sawn and all sorts, you know, the general chaos of daily life. Okay, today I'm taking you once again to the reign of King Henry VIII. It was a very eventful reign. For on this day in Tudor history, Sunday the 13th of May 1515, Mary Tudor, Dowager Queen of France and sister of King Henry VIII, married the King's good friend Charles Brandon, Duke of Suffolk at Greenwich Palace. Now, this wedding was their official marriage, in England at the Royal Court, following an earlier secret marriage, or possibly a couple of earlier secret marriages in France, because Charles Brandon had been sent to fetch Mary home from France to England after the death of her husband, King Louis XII of France. And she'd actually managed to get a deal from her brother, King Henry VIII, that if she married this elderly king, as she saw him, because she was 18 and he was in his 50s, that once he died, that she'd be able to marry a man of her choosing. That man, of course, turning out to be Charles Brandon. Now, this marriage at Greenwich Palace was recorded as taking place in the presence of the king and queen and such other nobles and estates of this realm as then were attending in the court. So a big official marriage. And it was said that all the said estates and others of this realm be very glad and well pleased. So a happy occasion for the royal court. Now, the Venetian ambassadors in London at the time recorded the event in a letter written on the 15th of May, so 2 days later in 1515. They wrote, "On the 13th instant, the espousals of Queen Mary to the Duke of Suffolk at length took place. There were no public demonstrations because the kingdom did not approve of the marriage. Wishing to ascertain whether this marriage had been concluded with the king's consent, were assured by great personages that it had first been arranged between the bride and bridegroom, after which they asked the consent of King Henry, who, however, had maintained his former friendship for the Duke, which would appear incredible, but is affirmed by the nobility at the court. Have therefore abstained from paying any compliments either to the king or to the bride and bridegroom, but have determined to visit his majesty in a day or two and congratulate him on his sister's arrival. Should they understand that the great personages of the court intend to make public mention of the event and that it was celebrated, they would then offer congratulations in the seigneury's name on the marriage, but not seeing it solemnised as becoming would keep silence to avoid giving offence." So you've got those Venetian ambassadors who are not quite sure of what to do and are being diplomatic. They're being diplomatic because they're not sure of the general feeling about this marriage and whether they're going to end up causing upset by congratulating those people concerned if King Henry VIII isn't pleased by this marriage. So I love that letter, it's great. Now, Mary and Charles Brandon, Duke of Suffolk, stayed married until Mary's death on the 25th of June 1533. And it was a successful marriage. They had four children together, Henry, Francis, Eleanor, and another Henry following the death of the first Henry. Unfortunately, their sons died in childhood, but Francis and Eleanor survived, and Francis of course ended up becoming the mother of Lady Jane Grey, Queen Jane as I like to call her, and Eleanor became Countess of Cumberland and the family went on. Of course, Charles Brandon, after Mary's death, very quickly married Catherine Willoughby, his teenage ward. But his marriage to Mary Tudor seems to have been happy and successful. So that's what happened on this day in King Henry VIII's reign. We've got the marriage of Mary Tudor, Queen of France, sister of Henry VIII, beloved sister of Henry VIII, and his best friend Charles Brandon, Duke of Suffolk. After upsetting the king by secretly marrying without his permission in France, they finally had a proper official marriage in England. So I will see you tomorrow with another Tudor history event. I'll actually give you a link to find out about their earlier marriage, the questions of over the date of when that happened. I did a video mentioning that, so I'll give you a link to that. But yeah, I'll see you tomorrow. You can subscribe by clicking round about there, and you can hit the bell to be notified. And if you're enjoying the series, then please do consider liking this video. Take care. Bye bye.